Welcome to the creation of the OER activity. In this open educational resource, we are showing you the different phases of conversion from source form to a final executable. In other words, we will show you the life cycle of a program as to how the transformation occurs from source form to the loader form. OER is being released under the Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 4.0 license. Related contents can be found on my blog page prabodhcp.wordpress.com. Okay, let me repeat, prabodhcp.wordpress.com. So a C program, as shown in the diagram, initially we use a text editor to write our program. The contents are in source format or in text format. So the first phase, as we know that there are several phases in the conversion from source form to the final executable form. The various phases as shown in the diagram is pre-processing, then compiling, assembling also happens here, then the object code is later linked and using a linker to finally get the executable file. This executable file is finally loaded onto the memory using a loader program. So the flowchart is shown here. The program in source file is first pre-processed, then later assembled, and then fed to the compiler. The compiler generates the corresponding object code. So what you have to note here is, no longer the code is in text form, the object file is now in the binary format. If there are any errors, the program does not compile, instead it issues the error messages. Then related object files are linked together. The references to any built-in functions are resolved using a special purpose software called as the linker, and this phase is called as the linking phase. After linking, we have the executable file, which is now ready for execution, and again the executable file is in binary format. Next, we use the loader software to load this executable into the memory and start the execution of the program. So this, in a nutshell, is how a program or a C program written in text format is finally converted into an executable program and then executed. In this OER, we are going to see each phase in slightly more detail. We will be using the GCC compiler and the GDB toolchain to demonstrate these tools. So to demonstrate this, we have a sample program. Let's have a look at the sample program. So this is a simple program that calculates and prints the areas of the circle. So here, this is just like any other C program, wherein we have a user-defined function circular area, which takes a single parameter, that's the radius. From main, we are going to invoke this function for different radius. In our program, we are checking for two instances where radius is 1 and radius is 5.0. And then later we are displaying the results. Below, we have the circular area function, which calculates the area of a circle using the relation pi into radius. R pi r square.